Alright, welcome LEGO fans to a LEGO Snowman review here on Bilbo Bricko9's channel. So, this is one of my last seasonal Christmas reviews for the year 2013. I might get a couple more next year, don't know, because that's still a year away. We have one more review coming, hopefully, and that will be Andrew 19, Andrew Fleury's Christmas Tree, which he's going to loan to us. Other than that, it's just going to be a few more days of advent calendars. So, make sure if you haven't seen all the others, including the Winter Village Bakery and Santa's Sleigh, that you check those out. But anyway, you're here for the snowman right now, so let's go ahead and take a look at him. Now, I don't have the bag or the instructions to show you, but I did pull up the specifics and virtual instructions on the computer. So let's go ahead and look at those right now.
Today is Thursday, yes?
Alright, so first of all, let's take a look at the specifics. So there's the picture. If it doesn't look exactly like the one I have, that's because it isn't. I made a few modifications to mine, which I'll tell you about in a little bit. So it's set 30008, contains 44 pieces, $3.49 in the UK, and AU free. LEGO Club. So, either 350 or free. Not bad for the number of pieces, which is 44. Ages 6 to 10, and released in 2009 under the themes Creator, Holiday, and Seasonal, which I've heard of all of those except Holiday. Thought it was just all seasonal. Anyway, as for the virtual instructions, let's go ahead and take a look at those. That's what the polybag looked like. Then, here is page 1. So, you can see that. Pretty straightforward and simple. Then page 2. Well, there's a picture of the actual bag. And then page 2 of the instructions is down here. And it included a free child admission to Legoland, California. And some advertisements for other sets right there. So let's go ahead and take a look at the actual snowman. Alright, so here he is. As I mentioned before, I made a few modifications. First of all, I was missing a base plate, which should have gone right there. So, it might seem a little flimsy, but it works for me. I just attached them there instead of putting the base plate in there, because I didn't feel like looking for it. But I don't think it's a big deal. And then the other modification I made was not out of necessity. I just added these two inverted tiles down here instead of leaving it like that. So, let me know which one you like better. You could put the tiles any way you wanted to. That is how I chose to do it. But anyway, as for the rest of the snowman, he's got two black buttons down there. Nice red scarf, orange carrot nose. It would have been nice if they actually used a carrot piece. I don't know how they would have attached it, but it would have been a nice addition, I thought. Big black top hat there, which fits onto his head. And then he's got two tiny arms, and one of them is holding this broom, which is only made out of three pieces, including a jumper plate, and, well, you know the rest. And the arms move, as you can see. Now, one thing is that he kind of looks like an evil snowman. He's got these very small, beady eyes. And he just looks very angry. So let me know what you think. Do you think this looks like an evil snowman or just a regular snowman? But anyway, other than that, that is about it to say about him. So let's go ahead and get to the ratings. For the build, I will give it a 4 because I wanted the carrot piece here, and then those beady eyes just don't look right. And also his arms seem very tiny, whoops, for his body size. So I'm going to have to give it a 4. For play, a 1, only because you can move the arms. I'll give it that. Otherwise, if you couldn't move the arms, it'd be a 0. And some of you may think that it's still a 0, but because you can move the arms, I'll give it a 1, just to be nice to this here snowman. But as we know, polybags aren't meant for play. They are meant for build, display, and adding on to bigger displays is usually what people buy them for. And finally, for display, well, one thing I will note, if you haven't seen this yet, this is my 2013 Christmas display stand, which I think is coming along nicely. I've done reviews for everything that is on that stand, including the advent calendars. Now, I would add the snowman, but I'm not going to, because that would just look a bit weird, having that giant snowman there, who's like 2 times as tall as a minifigure. That would just look a bit weird. So I'll probably just display that separately, but by itself. I don't know, 6? I would give it higher, because, I mean, it's an alright looking snowman. But, and he's a little flat in the back there too. But the only reason I'm not giving it higher is because of that, and then those beady little eyes. So, there is your Lego Snowman review. Thanks for tuning in. Make sure you don't miss all of our other seasonal reviews, including the 2013 Christmas special, the Winter Village Bakery review, all the advent calendar reviews, Polybags. We got all kinds of Christmas stuff on here, and all kinds of other stuff too. Lord of the Rings, Hobbit, Star Wars, Lego reviews. So don't miss those. Merry Christmas, and we will see you next time. And random Gandalf battling a giant snowman. Who will win this battle?